Commander, I think you'll want to talk to Garrus. How may I help you, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
Garrus received some news that put fire in his eyes. Maybe you should speak with him down in the main battery. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
Take care.
There you are. I can see why Jack is the way she is. I don't like it, but I get it. The Normandy runs so quietly. I'm not used to hearing my footsteps when I walk.
Shepard, I'm glad you came by. I've got something. I may need your help. You remember Sidonis, the one who betrayed my team? I found a lead on him. There's a specialist on the Citadel, name's Fade. He's an expert at helping people disappear. Sidonis was seen with him.
Where do we find Fade?
I've arranged a meeting. We'll meet him in a warehouse near the Neon Markets down on Zakara Ward. Thanks, Shepard. I appreciate you taking the time to help me.
Kenneth, what has the new shielding done to your power grid balance?
Not much. With built-in capacitor subsystems, they have a surprisingly low draw.
Doesn't that mean the shielding boost wouldn't last long under fire?
True. They're built for hard, fast strikes, not firefights of attrition.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
Have you got time to talk?
I really need to clean up this engine. Maybe later?
I'll let you work.
Talk to you later.
I needed to wipe that place off the map. You took me there to do it, and I owe you.
You don't know what it's like, Shepard, to have garbage like that following you. It marks you in ways you don't expect.
I've made a lot of hard choices, Jack. Like what to let go.
Hard to walk away from it. You'd think it would get easier now that the place is a crater. But what else do I know?
I never thought I'd see you show mercy, but you let Eresh live.
He was trapped in the past, reliving it every day. You showed how that could be me. I'm not getting stuck like that. I'm better than him, and I'm sure as hell not carrying that crater around with me.
Do you think you're different now?
I know that place is gone, but I still kind of want to kill every person I see. No offense.
I'll take what I can get with you, Jack.
You did a lot, Shepard. Shit. I'm not good at this soft stuff. Just... thanks, okay? Let's get back to work.
Shepard, I was just waxing goddamn nostalgic. I knew this girl once, Asari, good head on her shoulders. We had this whole thing going, until she sold me out to the Blood Pack, put a sour note on the relationship. Doesn't matter who you are, you got a gun in your face, chances are good you'll do what the other man says. Only two types don't buckle at that point. Train killers and psychopaths. A lot of people can't tell the difference. I should let you go. Talk more later, Shepard.
anomaly detected.
Repeat. There's a piece of crap mech on this planet's surface. If you think you can get it to work, you're freaking welcome to it.
Scans have found something.
Walls. Heavy explosives will be required to excavate them.
message coming in from the Elusive Man. Patch him in through the comm.
The Elusive Man wishes to speak to you in the debriefing.
Passing the Elusive Man through, Commander.
Shepard, we caught a break. I intercepted a distress call from a Turian patrol. They stumbled onto a collector ship beyond the Corliss system. The Turians were wiped out, but not before they crippled the collector vessel. I need you to board that ship and get some hard data on the collectors. Find us a way to get to their home world.
Hard to imagine how a Turian patrol could take out a collector ship.
Reports indicate the hull's intact, but all systems seem to be offline. They could be making repairs as we speak. I'm not saying it won't be dangerous, but we can't let an opportunity like this slip by.
If they had a patrol out there, why aren't the Turians sending a recon team in?
They will, eventually. But I intercepted the transmissions. In the meantime, we're feeding them false reports. You're close enough that you can be in and out before the Turians learn the truth.
Are you sure this information is good?
Information is my weapon, Shepard. It's good.
Send me the coordinates and I'll take care of it.
Already sent. Once you're aboard the ship, establish an uplink with Edie. She'll mine their data for information regarding the Omega-4 relay. Good luck, Shepard.
Coordinates punched in. Let's go find us a collector ship.
We have a visual on the collector ship, Commander.
Very low emissions. Passive infrared temperatures suggest most systems are offline. Thrusters are cold.
That thing is massive. How the hell did the Turians take it out?
LADAR scans do not detect any hull breaches on the side facing us. I detect no mass effect field distortions. It appears the drive core is offline.
Rendezvous in 30 seconds, Commander. Good luck.
Looks like a giant insect hive.
Penetrating scans have detected an access node to uplink with collector data banks. Marking location to your hardsuit, Shepard, I've compared the ship's EM signature to known collector profiles. It is the vessel you encountered on Horizon.
Maybe the defense tower softened it for the Turians.
The colonists might be on board, if they're still alive. The collectors use the same containers on Horizon, but these are empty.
It must have been horrible. Trapped in these pods, helpless, completely at the mercy of the collectors. What happened here?
Bodies just left here. They're just things to the collectors.
They must have been used for testing. If they were a control group, they would have been discarded at the end of the experiment.
There are worse things than death. Like being a test subject for twisted aliens.
I know you're right, but it doesn't make me feel any better. Thank you.
that's a collector. They experimented on one of their own?
Edie, I'm uploading the data from this terminal. See if you can figure out what they were up to.
Data received. Analyzing. The collectors were running baseline genetic comparisons between their species and humanity.
Are they looking for similarities?
I have no hypothesis on their motivations. All I have are the preliminary results. They reveal something remarkable. A quad-strand genetic structure identical to traces collected from ancient ruins. Only one race is known to have this structure, the Protheans.
My God. The Protheans didn't vanish. They're just working for the Reapers now.
These are no longer Prothean, Shepard. Their genes show distinct signs of extensive genetic rewrite. The Reapers have repurposed them to suit their needs.
You'd think somebody would have picked up on this.
No one has had an opportunity to study a collector genetic code in this detail. I've already matched 2,000 alleles to recorded fragments. This collector likely descends from a Prothean colony in the Styx Theta Cluster. But there are signs of extreme alteration. 3 fewer chromosomes. Reduced heterochromatin structure. Elimination of superfluous junk sequences.
The Reapers didn't wipe out the Protheans. They turned them into monsters and enslaved them. Still, they're working for the Reapers now, and we have to stop them.
I sure as hell won't follow the Protheans to this.
Let's find what we need before the collectors come to salvage this vessel. Move out.
Look, on the ceiling. More of those strange pots.
Must be hundreds. And how many are full?
Too many.
I detect no signs of life in the pod, Shepard. It is probable the victims inside died when the ship lost primary power.
This should come in handy.
Commander, you gotta hear this. On a hunch, I asked Edie to run an analysis on this ship.
I compared the EM profile against data recorded by the original Normandy 2 years ago. They are an exact match.
The same ship dogging me for 2 years? Way beyond coincidence.
Something doesn't add up, Commander. Watch your back.
Stop them.
There, on the platform. Looks like some kind of control panel.
Something's not right. We haven't seen any collector bodies. No crew.
Edie, I'm setting up a bridge between you and the collector ship. See if you can get anything useful from the databanks.
Data mine in progress, Shepard.
That can't be good.
Everyone's all right, Joker. What just happened?
Major power surge. Everything went dark, but we're back out now.
I managed to divert the majority of the overload to non-critical systems. Shepard, it was not a malfunction. This was a trap.
We need a little help here, Edie.
I am having trouble maintaining connection. There's someone else in the system.
Regained control of the platform, Shepard.
I knew you wouldn't let us down, Edie.
I always work at optimal capacity.
Did you get what we needed?
I found data that would help us successfully navigate the Omega-4 relay. I have also found a Turian distress call that served as the lure for this trap. The collectors were the source. It is unusual.
Seems logical to me that they would have sent the initial message as bait.
No, it is unusual because Turian emergency channels have secondary encryption. It is corrupted in the message. It is not possible that the elusive man would believe the distress call was genuine.
Why are you so sure?
I found the anomaly with Cerberus detection protocols. He wrote them.
He knew it was a trap? Why would he send us into a trap?
That son of a bitch sent us right into collector hands.
We should have known this would happen. Cerberus can't be trusted.
There's got to be an explanation. The elusive man wouldn't do this. It doesn't make sense.
Commander, we got another problem. The collector ship is powering up.
You need to get out of there before their weapons come online. I'm not losing another Normandy.
I do not have full control of their systems. I will do what I can. Sending coordinates for shuttle extraction.
Come on, let's move.
Behind.
Shepard. genetic destiny. I know you feel this. You are the harbinger of your destiny.
Shepard, looks like Edie extracted some interesting data before the collector ship came back online.
Cut the act. You set us up, and you better have a damn good reason for it.
We needed information on the Omega 4 relay. That required direct access to collector data. It was too good an opportunity to pass up.
Agreed. But I don't like surprises, especially when my ass is on the line.
I put you at risk, yes. But without that information, we don't reach the Collector homeworld, and you and every other human may as well be dead. It was a trap, but I was confident in your abilities. And don't forget Edie. The Collectors couldn't have anticipated her.
You could have told me the plan. You say I'm important, but you sure try hard to get me killed.
I needed the Collectors to believe they had the upper hand. Telling you could have tipped them off in any number of ways. Besides, I wouldn't have sent you in if I didn't think you could succeed.
I don't risk people. There are always alternatives.
You may not like being on the receiving end, neither would I. But the facts are with me. As much as we try to avoid them, these decisions need to be made. But more importantly, it paid off. Edie confirmed our suspicions. The Reapers and Collector ships use an advanced identify-friend-foe system that the relays recognize. All we need to do is get our hands on one of those IFFs.
I was just on the Collector ship. Why didn't you say anything about finding their IFF?
As I said, Edie just confirmed it. Besides, you wouldn't have had time to find and extract it. But we have options. An Alliance science team recently determined that the Great Rift on the planet Klendigan is actually an impact crater from a mass accelerator weapon. A very old mass accelerator. I sent a team to find either the weapon or its target. They found both. The weapon was defunct, but it helped us plot the flight path of the intended target, a 37 million year old derelict Reaper. We found it damaged and trapped in the gravity of a brown dwarf.
Aren't brown dwarves basically stars that didn't quite make it?
Simply put, but accurate, they're gas giants that don't quite have the masses of stars. Expect gale force winds and extremely high temperatures. The Reaper has a mass effect field that keeps it in orbit, likely an automated response to the external threats. It's stable, but I won't call it safe.
I saw what Sovereign did to the Citadel fleet. Hard to imagine anything could stop something that powerful.
This vessel is a relic from a battle waged while mammals took their first steps on Earth. There's no trace of the species that took the shot. Perhaps it was their one moment of defiance before being wiped out.
I get the feeling this isn't going to be a simple swing by and pick up our package.
We lost contact with Dr. Chandana's team shortly after they boarded. Initial reconnaissance revealed no clues, and it was too risky to commit more resources. But now we need that IFF. I'll forward the coordinates to Joker. In the meantime, I suggest you tell your crew I didn't risk their lives unnecessarily. It will make things easier going forward.
Edie, tell the crew to assemble. We've got a lot to talk about.
Of course, Shepard.
So the elusive man didn't sell us out. Could have fooled me.
Lied to us, used us, needed access to the Collector databanks. Necessary risk.
He tries something like that again, and the Collectors will be the least of his problems. Edie, are you sure this IFF is going to work?
My analysis is accurate, Shepard. I have also determined the approximate location of the Collector homeworld, based on navigational data from their vessel.
That can't be right.
Edie doesn't make mistakes. The Collector homeworld is located somewhere in the galactic core.
Can't be. The core is just black holes and exploding suns. There are no habitable planets there.
Could be an artificial construction, space station protected by powerful mass effect fields and radiation shields.
Even the Collectors don't have that kind of technology.
The Collectors are just servants of our real enemy, and we've all seen what their masters are capable of. They built the mass relays in the Citadel. Who's to say they can't build a space station surrounded by black holes? No wonder nobody's ever returned from a trip through the Omega-4 mass relay.
The logical conclusion is that a small safe zone exists on the far side of the relay, a region where ships can survive. Standard relay transit protocols would not allow safe transport. Drift of several thousand kilometers is common, and would be fatal in the galactic core. The Reaper IFF must trigger the relay to use more advanced encrypted protocols.
Just because we can follow the Collectors through the relay doesn't mean we can take them out. I don't want to go after him until I know we're ready.
Sooner or later, we need that IFF. I say, why wait?
It's a derelict Reaper. What if the Collectors are waiting for us? We may want to build up our team before we take that kind of risk.
The more people we have on our side, the better our chances of success. We need to keep building up the team.
It's your call, Commander. Whatever you decide, we're with you.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. You had me so worried when you were trapped on the Collector ship. Thank goodness for Edie.
That sounds like more than just professional concern, Kelly.
You're more than just my commander. You're my friend.
Edie brought you back to me. If she had a body, I'd give her a big hug.
I'm standing right here. Where's my hug?
Oh, Shepard. I wish there were time to get to know you better.
When things settle down, I hope we'll find some time to get to know each other better.
I look forward to that day. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
So the Collectors were once Protheans, repurposed by the Reapers. What a sad end.
Makes you wonder if the Keepers on the Citadel were once something different.
Commander.
So, how do you think we're doing?
Well, the Normandy's good. Everything's upgraded and better than ever. If we're talking about the crew, you'd probably have to ask a people person.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Once Protheans.
I always pictured Protheans being regal, not giant bugs.
Who knows what the Reapers did to them? Creepy.
How may I help you, Commander?
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander.
Just thinking about you. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way.
Access to life support is restricted.
Thinking about past missions. Got a minute. You might learn something. Collectors and Protheans. It's all about my pay grade. I'm more used to putting down rebellions, tracking down bastards who didn't pay their gambling debts. Still, even I know a galaxy-shaking revelation when I hear one. Makes fighting land wars for pay seem small time. I was shadowing this rookie on an infiltration run to an Eclipse base on Tatus. Good kid, but he had no business handling a rifle. In the shuttle on the way down, he puked in his helmet. We hit some turbulence, and with all the crap sloshing around, he thought he'd been shot in the head. Went back to the Alliance. Here he's a governor now.
Shepard, I'm glad you came by. I may need your help. I just received a message from the Migrant Fleet. The Admiralty Board has accused me of treason. I'm scared, Shepard.
Nobody who knows you could believe you'd betray your people, Tally.
I don't know. They don't lay charges like this unless the evidence seems absolute. But thanks. I appreciate your faith in me, Shepard.
Is it because you're working with Cerberus?
I'm not working with Cerberus. I'm working with you. And I got leave to serve on the Normandy again. I have no idea what they're accusing me of. You'd think I would remember if I betrayed the fleet.
What happens when a Quarian is accused of treason?
There's a hearing, with members of the Admiralty Board acting as judges. My father is an admiral on the board. He'll have to recuse himself from judgment. Can't even imagine what he's thinking right now. The punishment for treason is exile. If they convict me, I can never go back.
So how does the trial work? How soon do we need to get you there?
They'll wait a reasonable period of time for me to come and defend myself. Eventually, if I don't show up, they'll try me in absentia. As for how it works, it's less formal than an Earth trial or something you'd see on the Citadel. We're family. This is just the worst kind of family meeting.
So you have no idea why they're accusing you?
None. The specifics of charges like this are rarely discussed on open channels. I won't know any more until I get to the flotilla.
What happens if you're convicted?
Like I said, exile. The specifics are up to the judges. If it's deemed only a tragic mistake in judgment, the guilty party might receive a small ship and supplies. Not that it really matters. Either way, if I'm convicted, I'll never see the migrant fleet again.
So no prison and no death penalty?
We don't have the spare resources for long-term incarceration. Monitored work detail is more effective. And we don't have enough people to afford executions. An exile can still have children, and those children are welcomed back to the fleet.
How often is someone from the fleet charged with treason?
It's rare. It must be something that affects the entire flotilla, not just one ship. The most recent one was Honora Vanya Vassalani, an engineer who handed over fleet defense schematics to the Batarians. She had good intentions. The Batarians were contracted to upgrade our systems, but they passed the defense schematics to a pirate gang.
Was she convicted?
No. She made a suicide run on the pirate gang. She destroyed them before they could attack the fleet. She was pardoned, posthumously. Let's hope I don't have to prove my innocence that way.
Okay, let's go find the flotilla.
I was going to book passage on another ship. I didn't think there would be time for you to help. Thank you, Shepard. I'll program the Normandy with the flotilla's current location. The admirals will be waiting for us.
Hey.
What's happening?
You got a lot of questions, don't you?
I miss your friendly nature when you're not around.
Been thinking. We've seen a lot of shit together now, and you're always coming to talk to me.
Shepard, you got feelings for me? Because I don't need the complication.
Then don't worry. I'm not interested.
Good. I didn't want you coming around here anymore anyway.
Is there a problem, Jack?
Can't figure if you're playing me or not. I don't like it.
Then stop.
You'd like that. Make this about you and what you want.
I have to think. Go away. I don't want you coming around here for a while.